In this video, I'll talk about three very similar Substance Painter tools. All of them are used to project image into our mesh, but each one of them are useful in different situations, depending on what kind of job we are doing. For example, the projection and physical projection tools are useful for blending materials and adding stickers or logos to our models, and the stencil tool is better for creating complex masks. I'll start with the projection tool. You can start using it selecting the tool on the left menu or pressing number 3 on your keyboard. While we are using it, on the properties panel we will find the different texture channels from our project, so we can fill them with the maps of the texture we want to project. For example, I have some dirt textures from textureheaven.com with the base color, roughness and normal map, so I can fit them to the projection tool and start working with them. On the tiling setting we can set our tiling to the default no tiling or vertical tiling, horizontal one or both at the same time. After setting our textures, we can start painting over our model on the viewport. Pressing the S key along right mouse, left mouse or middle mouse click, we can rotate, zoom or move our projection tool. Don't worry if you forget any of these hotkeys, because by pressing just the S key, Substance will show a little cheat sheet with all the options you have. The last configuration about these tools I want to mention is that if you go to the display menu, there is a section called tool display, where you can configure the tool opacity, the channel display by default, and choose between hiding the stencil while painting or not. Every brush is available, but for blending different textures, usually it's better to use softer brushes. I'm gonna paint with the material I already had set, and then at any moment you can change the textures and use a different one, like this for example. For a better blending, works pretty well to paint a bit using a low opacity brush to get a softer transition between materials. Okay, that looks a bit better, but anyway, I'll delete this paint layer to talk about how we can use projection to create stickers or paint logos and different stuff into our model, maybe the most common use of this tool. For that, I'm gonna use this electricity signal I got from textures.com and edited using Photoshop to remove the background and bring a PNG image with transparency. Even if I only have the base color from this signal texture, I could put here a procedural roughness from Substance Painter or another texture so we can get more information. But for now I'm gonna delete the roughness and normal map from the previous dirt texture, because I don't think a stone shaper roughness is gonna look very nice here. Before painting the sticker, I'm gonna bring up a bit the height information. And as you can see, the color looks nice, but the height is a bit strange, because it's painting even where the image is just an alpha channel, so the light changes created by the height information aren't where they are supposed to be. To fix this, I brought a mask also created on Photoshop, so after painting the base color without moving the projection tool, I can create a black mask from this layer and paint it using this mask. After this, I can create a new fill layer with a mask, copy the paint layer from the previous black mask, and use this fill layer to adjust the height, roughness, or any information we want. A better way to do this would be with anchor points, but as I can be sure that everyone knows how to use anchor points, I'll copy the effect this time, and in the future I'll make a video talking about anchor points and how to use them. For now, to continue with the projection tools, next one in the list is physical projection, hidden inside the previous projection tool, but you can access it pressing down the left menu button or using the hotkey Ctrl+3. This tool works exactly as the previous one, but instead of painting with a brush, you paint using particles. On the properties menu you can find a new section called physics with two main options, emitter and receiver. Emitter is the different ways we can launch the particles towards our model. For example, manual rain send random particles where we use our brush, while single particles spawn them one by one, as the name implies. Rain makes particles rain above the 3D model, and also it's very laggy, takes a while to calculate. On the other hand, receiver changes the way particles react or move when touch the surface of your model. There's a lot of them, like burning, glass or spiral. Along with the emitters, each option has a lot of different parameters to configure, so try to experiment on your own to get the effect you need on any given situation. In contrast to the previous projection tool that has a very obvious functionality to create stickers or project complex texture into the model, this physical projection tool I don't think it has a very specific function attached to it. I've never used it on a personal project besides from testing and learning it, and I think I've never seen anyone use it or talk about it on articles or videos, so the best use I can think for it is to get a bit better blending between two textures, similar to what I did before with the projection tool, but instead of painting manually, physical projection could be used to get some last details projected on a more random way. Also, you could use this to project something like rust, for example, on a metal surface with organic distribution, but still, this is something I think I could achieve easier using a fill layer with a black mask on it, and just paint the black mask using the particle process that Substance Painter has included by default. So, in any case, it's always good to know every tool the software has to offer, because it could be useful one day. So leave a comment if you think about any interesting use case for this tool. At last, let's say you want to use an image texture to paint a mask. For example, I'm using these grunge textures that come shipped with Substance Painter. If I use the projection tool explained before, it takes all the texture into account while painting. So the white parts will show the mask, and the black parts of the texture will paint black the mask. So it's impossible to blend the different scratches and details on this texture. The solution for this is the stencil option found on the brush tool. The options are very similar to the projection tool ones, setting an image texture here and setting the tiling we need. Then the control is exactly the same as when working with the projection tool, but now it's a stencil, so I can mix details and scratches on my mask and create this kind of tree-shaped scratch I'm doing right now. Take into account that the stencil option just understands black and white textures, and if you use any texture with color information, it will still paint black and white. So it's perfect to create complex masks, but for stickers and logos, stick to the projection tool. And that will be all there is to talk about these tools. Very basic stuff, but still essential to work properly on Substance Painter. So thanks for watching and have a nice day.